My name is Laura Morgan, and I'm with the Solano Resource Conservation District, or the SRCD for short. Normally, during this time, I am outside teaching students like yourself, or teachers, or anyone interested about what their watershed looks like, what it is, how it works, and how we can protect it. But I am stuck inside my house, probably just like you are, whoever you are that's watching me. And so I decided to take a moment out of my day to teach you about what a watershed is, how it works, and why it's important to protect it. When I'm talking about a watershed, I am talking about an area of land that water flows from the highest points down to the lowest points, collecting in streams and creeks, and then eventually flowing out into the ocean. We name our watershed based on the biggest body of water in our area that all of our waterways collect into, okay? So, I live in the Sacramento River watershed. The Sacramento River is the biggest river in California, and for me, where I live, that's where all of my water drains into. So this watershed model that I built is gonna show that. It's gonna show that water moving up from the highest points, from our mountains, down into smaller bodies of water, bigger bodies of water, and eventually into the ocean, which is my measuring cup. I used some cups and jars to kind of keep my model up. I also, just for fun, added some rocks. I got some animals, this little frog that I got right here, this frog mountain. So you can use all kinds of animals in your watershed model. And these are gonna be my trees, my forests. I got a picture of Half Dome, which is in Yosemite. So, you know, just to set the scene, set the mood. So we got our landscape, right? And now, we're gonna bring in some rain. So I got this spray bottle. I'm gonna pretend that I'm a storm cloud and it's raining outside right now. So this is what's happening in real life right now, all right? So I am gonna take my spray bottle, I'm gonna make it rain all over this watershed. So let's amp this up a little bit. We don't have all day. I'm not here to waste anyone's time. Now, where is that water moving? Nice. So let's say I live like right here. We can call this the Sacramento River. So this can be my watershed, but it's flowing out into the ocean, just right over there, right? Now someone in a different part of the county can live over here. Their watershed might be the Sassoon Marsh. But either way, our watershed are coming together right into the Pacific Ocean. So remember, we learned about water going from the highest points down to the lowest points. Why does it do that, you ask? Gravity. Gravity's pulling down on that water, and that water is just trying to move to the lowest possible place, right? And that is the ocean. Now, check this out. We're gonna introduce some pollution to our watershed motto. Since we all live in a watershed all over the world, people might be leaving things behind that can get introduced into our water and make our water dirty. That can be our local rivers or our creeks or our ocean too. So I'm gonna pretend that this red stuff is trash, right? So maybe, I'll put some trash over here. Maybe I'll put some over here too. We might be driving around in cars, not very much right now, but in general, you know, we drive around. And if anyone has a little bit of an oil leak, maybe their car leaks some oil, super toxic, yucky stuff that we don't want in our water. And maybe somebody's walking their dog and they don't clean up after their dog, and maybe there's just a bunch of dog poop, right? This time we're gonna create another rainstorm. Maybe it's supposed to rain tomorrow. And we have all of our pollutants, our dog waste, our motor oil, all of our trash. Do you think that that's gonna sit tight where it is, or do you think it's gonna go somewhere? Where do you think it's gonna go? What watershed do you live in? Do you remember that? All right, so let's make this rainstorm happen. Speed this process up, we don't have all day.
Ooh.
How is our water looking now? Is it looking blue? Like normal water looks? Or does it look disgusting and black, like polluted water? Why don't we zoom in on that? Let's zoom in on that. Ooh. Yeah, that looks a little nasty. I would not want to drink that water. Do you think this frog would want to jump into that water? Absolutely not. So, I want you to think about what can you do to protect your watershed. Whether that's the Sacramento River, or San Pablo Bay, or Carquinez Strait, or the Sassoon Marsh, what actions can you take at home, or when you're out on a walk with your family, or you're getting groceries at the grocery store? What can you do to keep your water clean and healthy? All right, so thanks for tuning in. Once again, my name is Laura Morgan. I work for the Solano RCD, and I hope to see you outside exploring nature, protecting our watershed in the very near future.